Hello and welcome. In this video, we're going to see how to install Unity on a Linux computer. Many people think that you can only use Unity on Windows, but that's not the case. And actually, Unity works pretty well on Unity. The installation process is a bit tricky, but we're going to do it step by step, so it won't be a problem. Let's start by opening a browser and download the Unity Hub. Let's save the file. And it was downloaded to the downloads folder. So let's open the downloads folder. And here is the Unity Hub application. Unity Hub is the management tool of Unity. Using it, we will manage the development environment, the licenses, the projects, and everything else. To be able to run it, let's right click on it and go to properties. And we need to add the execute permission. So let's go to the permissions tab and tick this checkbox, allow executing file as program. And now we can double click on it and it will open. We can see the Unity terms of service. I'm going to agree. Great, and Unity Hub is open. Next step is going to be Mono installation. Mono is a project that allows us to compile and run C# code on Linux machines, actually on non-Windows machines. In our case, it's Linux. So let's download Mono from the Mono project website. There are instructions for macOS, Linux, Windows, and Docker. We are interested in Linux, of course. And there are several supported distros. I'm using Ubuntu, so I'll stick to the Ubuntu instructions. Let's open a terminal. My version is Ubuntu 20.04, so I'm going to copy these commands. Okay, we added Mono to the repository of the system. Now let's move on to installing Mono. Let's confirm it. Okay, Mono is being installed. It will take a few minutes. So as we said, the purpose of Mono is to be able to compile and run C# code on Linux. It will be very useful when we will want to add scripts to our Unity scenes. So let's verify the installation. We're going to write a Hello World simple program in C# and run it. So here is the page of the verification. I'll create a temporary folder for testing the Mono installation. And they want us to create a hello.cs file, so let's do that. And let's copy the code and paste it. Now I'm going to save the file using Ctrl S and exit using Ctrl X. To compile, I'm going to use this command. And let's list the files. And apart from the source code, the CS file we created ourselves, we can also see the hello.exe, which is the result of the compilation. To run the file, let's run this command, mono, and then the name of the exe file. And we got hello mono world. So mono is working, and we can continue with the Unity installation. So first we need to log in the Unity Hub. We can do it here, sign in. If you already have a Unity ID, use it and sign in. I'm going to create a new one. So I need to type in my email, my password, a username, and my name. We now need to agree to the Unity Terms of Service and to the Privacy Policy. We can also tick the third box if we want to receive marketing emails. I now need to confirm my email. So let me head over to my email and click the link that Unity sent me. And let me make sure that I'm not a robot. Okay, I'm not a robot. And my email was verified, and I now have a new Unity ID. Let's get back to the Unity Hub. Okay, I'm now logged in, and as you can see, my initials appear in the top right corner. But currently I don't have any valid license. So let's click on the cog and click on license management and let's activate new license. I'm going to choose Unity Personal and I don't use Unity in a professional capacity. Great, my license was successfully activated. Next thing is going to be installing Unity itself. Now, theoretically, it should be done from here, from installs. Then you should add one of the Unity releases. The problem with this method is that it's unreliable. Many times it fails and it's a big file, so starting over takes a long time. If you're feeling lucky, go ahead, choose one of the versions and click on next. But what I'm going to do is use a link that will appear in the description of the video below. Click on the link and you will download the very same release from the browser. The advantage of using Firefox to download the release is that if it fails in the middle, we won't have to start over. We can resume the download, which is not possible from Unity Hub. So I'm going to do it from Firefox. And let's save the file. Okay, it's downloading. And as you can see, the download failed. Why it was downloading? Just in the middle. Luckily, since we are downloading using Firefox, we can just click on this arrow and retry download, and it will continue from the point it got to, instead of starting over. And Unity was downloaded. It will now appear in the Downloads folder. And as you can see, it's a tar archive. Let's extract the contents of the tar archive. I'm going to use the terminal to extract it. And it's important to have patience in this step. Wait for the terminal to finish before moving on. Once it's done, we know that this new folder editor contains all of the contents it should contain. Let's create a new folder. I'm going to call it Unity Hub. Now let's close Unity Hub. And I'm going to move to the new folder two things. Unity Hub itself and the editor, which is the folder we just extracted from the tar archive. And now let's open Unity Hub again. And let's go to the Installs tab. But this time, instead of adding, I'm going to locate. And let's head over to the Unity Hub folder. And here, from inside the editor, I'm going to select Unity. Here it is. This is the file we want. Let's select editor. And we can see it under the installs. It's here, it's ready. Now, one annoying thing that you might encounter is that if you look for Unity Hub in the start menu, you won't find it. You will find the folder that contains it, but you won't find it as an application. So let's fix that. To do that, I'm going to install a small tool called Flameshot to take screenshots. Let's open Flameshot. And I'm going to save the Unity Hub icon as an image. I'll save it in my Unity Hub folder. Let's close Unity Hub. And now let's create the shortcut to Unity Hub. So first, let's change directory to the applications directory. And we're going to create a new file here, unity.desktop. First, we need to specify that it's a desktop entry. Then its type, which is application. Then let's give it a name, which will be Unity Hub. And now we need to specify the path to the executable file. And the last thing is the icon, which is the image we just took. Let's save the file by Ctrl S and exit by Ctrl X. And now we can look for Unity in the start menu. And we will find Unity Hub. So it doesn't really change anything, it's just nicer. Let's now create a workspace folder for our Unity projects. And we're ready to create our first Unity project. So let's get back to the Unity Hub, and under Projects, let's create New. Let's give it a name. And let's choose the workspace as the location. And Unity is up and running. We now need to configure our environment for script editing. I'm going to use Visual Studio Code. So let's download Visual Studio Code. And I'm going to download the dev package for Ubuntu. Let's open the terminal again and change directory to the downloads folder. And it's a dev package, so I'm going to use the package to install it. Okay, we now have Visual Studio Code installed, and we need to tell Unity to use Visual Studio Code as its script editor. To do that, let's get back to Unity, and let's go Edit, Preferences, External Tools, and as External Script Editor, I'm going to choose Visual Studio Code. Let's add a sphere, just as an example. And let's add a new C# script. Let's now attach the script to the sphere. And we can see that the sphere has the script. And if we double click on the script, it opens Visual Studio Code. Visual Studio Code identified that we opened the C# file, and it's recommending to install the appropriate extension. But instead of doing it from this pop-up, I'm going to go to the Extensions tab and look for C#. And here's the extension that Visual Studio Code recommended. Let's install it. Okay, it's installed. Let's now create a very simple script, one that says hi when the scene is started. And let's test it and see if it's working. And here you can see hello from VS Code. So it's working. The only problem we currently have is that auto completion doesn't work. I mean, it works for stuff like using. But it's not working for Unity related stuff. For example, if I'm starting to write debug, well, it knows it because I already used it. But if I now add dot, autocompletion does nothing. To fix that, let's go File, Preferences, Settings. And here I'm going to look for Global Mono, because we want Visual Studio Code to use Mono, which we installed in the beginning. And in the drop-down box, I'm going to change it from Auto to Always. Let's restart OmniSharp. And now, if I try dot again, auto completion does work, and I can find log and everything else. And everything that's related to Unity will be auto completed as well. Thanks for watching, and good luck with your Unity journey.